Dear friends, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless in the name of the Lord Jesus. Knowing this union, the union of husband and wife, in heart, body, and mind, is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another, prosperity and person. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into lightly, irreverently, deliberately, in accordance with the purpose for which it was instituted by God. Let us pray. Of this tangled world, Lord God, you have drawn together these two persons and are binding them firmly together by short insight and love. Bless these as they come to affirm the choice that they have made of each other as a life's mate and their intention to establish. Grant them a seriousness of purpose, that they may be delivered from empty words and may you nurture them all the days of their lives, that their dreams and aspirations for life may find fulfillment in doing your will and all. As we share with them in the celebration of love on this occasion, may we all grow in the knowledge of the love of God through Jesus Christ our Lord. I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are revealed, that having seriously considered the holy covenant you're about to make, you do declare before God and all these witnesses your pledge and charge. You can be sure that if these vows are faithfully kept, as God's word demands, and if you seek to do the will of God, He will bless your marriage, grant you fulfillment in it, and establish your home in peace. Noah, we have something to be your wife. They live together in the holy relationship of marriage. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and support her in joy and in suffering, and forsaking all others, remain with her as long as you both shall live? We have Noah to be your husband. They live together in the holy relationship of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and support him in joy and in suffering, and forsaking all others, remain with him as long as you wish? He gives us one more. You may be seated. I would take a moment to recite a reading of the Holy Scripture. 1 Corinthians 13 is paraphrased by J.B. Phillips. If I were to speak with the combined elegance of man and angels, I should stir people like a fanfare of trumpets or the clashing of cymbals. Unless I had love, I should do nothing more. If I had the gift of foretelling the future and had in my mind not only human knowledge, but also the secrets of God, and if, in addition, I had that absolute faith which can move mountains, but had no love, I tell you, I should amount to nothing at all. If I were to sell my possessions to feed the hungry, and for my convictions, allow my body to be burned, and yet had no love, I should achieve precisely nothing. The love of which I speak is slow to be patient. It looks for a way of being constructed. It is not possessive. It is neither anxious to impress, nor does it cherish inflated ideas of its own importance. Love has good manners and does not pursue selfish revenge. It is not touchy. It does not compile statistics of evil or gloat over the weaknesses of other people. On the contrary, it is glad with all good people when truth prevails and knows no limit to its endurance, no end to its trust, no fading of its hope. It can outlast anything. In fact, it is the one thing that still stands when all else has fallen. For better, for richer, in sickness and in health, for our nature, for death, because it's my son. I pray that you might be mine to have a dog from this day forth, for better, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, loving to cherish, death and death is my son. The wedding ring is the outward and visible symbol signifying to all the uniting of these two persons in the holy relationship of marriage with the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Listen, O Lord, the giving and receiving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your favor, in Jesus Christ our Lord. This is about constant and abiding love. Forgiveness, it is the sin of my heart. This ring has helped me. Then we shall my love. Noah Sophia, today you are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your life with each other. As each of you hold your sand, the separate vessels represent your lives up to this moment. Individual. Noah and Sophia, as you pour, when the two are blended together, they represent an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. Each grain of sand represents to the mixture a lasting beauty that forever enriches the combination. Noah and Sophia, he said the grains of sand can never be separated into their individual vessels. So will your marriage be? Also at this time, they're both have wrote each other a love letter. And you're going to put it into the box. And it is sealed. And in 10 years, you're going to open it up and read your love letters. And each other. Now I have challenged him that every 10 years write a new love letter. And if you do it long enough, you'll live have a marriage of 150 years. So, there we go. Did you know Sophia? Have considered together to be married, and have witnessed the same before God and family and friends, and have sealed your promises with rings. I pronounce that God has made you husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one separate. This time I'd like to invite those who would like to invite you to join in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. May the Lord look with favor and give you his peace, now and forever. Amen. Dear friends, it is my privilege and pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Noah Dart.